September the 27th to October the 5th, 2014, was the first International Air Ambulance Week for radio amateurs, with 25 stations taking part. In Essex, the Essex Air Ambulance ran a Go Yellow campaign to raise awareness for their service, and the Essex Ham website went yellow for a week. We also put on three special event stations using the call sign GB2EAA, Essex Air Ambulance, from the Earls Colne Airfield, close to the county's Air Ambulance Service. On the first day of operation, we ran two stations, HF on 40 metres and also a 2 metre station.
GB2EAA.
EAA, Golf Bravo 2, Echo, Alpha, Alpha.
As well as being home to the Essex Air Ambulance, the Earls Colne Airfield is in use by the Anglian Flight Centres as a training school. We took the chance to get up close and personal to some of the aircraft. 40 metres was again the centre of attention as we looked to work other air ambulance stations around the country.
We've also been lucky enough to work some of the other International Air Ambulance Week stations on the air. I believe we've worked the Yorkshire Air Ambulance, the London one, and also the Great North Air Ambulance.
As we arrived to set up on the second day, the Essex Air Ambulance was out on a mission, and we shortly got to see the Air Ambulance land very close to us. Key to demonstrating what the hobby is all about is the guest message. Here's Kim, one of the team from Anglian Flight Centres, giving it a try.
My name is Kim, Kilo India Mike.
Well, well done, Kim, well done. That's the idea of amateur radio, Kim.
Back from the third mission of the day, the crew of the Essex Air Ambulance came to try their hands at amateur radio.
Yeah, thanks Dave, that's all received. I'm a critical care paramedic here. I'm on with Nikki, who's our pilot today, and Matt, who's our doctor.
My name's Dr. Matt O'Mara. I'm a critical care doctor. The air ambulance becomes the cherry on the icing of the cake, which you would want absolutely when you have your car crash or your heart attack. You would want the skills that we're able to bring to you to come to bear.
We had a good time transmitting on 40 metres, and we actually managed to get some guest messages out from the crew of the Essex Air Ambulance, and then we were offered the opportunity to go and look around the ambulance itself, the helicopter, and never seen amateur radio people move so quickly.
Louise Rosson, and I'm a critical care paramedic. The majority is about bringing the team, which can provide care that a hospital can, but to the scene and trying to improve the patient's care right there at the scene rather than the delay of getting to hospital.
Captain Nikki Smith, I'm the pilot of the Essex Air Ambulance. We'll first of all identify where the patient is or where the scene of the accident is. I'll orbit the aircraft, and while we do that, but also deciding where the most suitable landing site might be, what hazards there are, is it big enough, what's the approach going to be on the way in, are we going to be going over some wires? All of those things happen very quickly.
At the end of the day, time to put the helicopter to bed and for the Essex Ham team to take down their antennas. On the third day of operation, Essex Ham's Jim, 2E0RMI, and Pete, M0PSX, were in for a real treat. With the bad weather closing in, it was looking like many of the planned lessons at the busy Anglian flight centres would be cancelled. One of the company's pilots, Eddie Ford, had time to take us on a trip. We flew over much of North Essex, looking at some of the locations that Essex Hams have worked previously, such as the LV18 in Harwich, Walton Pier, the Naze Tower and the Harwich High Lighthouse. Jim took the controls of the Piper Cherokee for a while, trying a few gentle turns, before our all-too-brief flight came to an end, and it was back to the airfield.
All aircraft stop like that.
Okay.
The expected bad weather closed in, and we set up two HF stations in the warm and dry. Charlie M0PZT and Pete M0PSX working HF voice, with Peter G0DZB running Morse on 30 metres.
GB2KAA, this is GB2EAA.
With around 200 contacts made, some money raised for the Essex Air Ambulance, and contacts made with eight other air ambulance stations, a very successful 3 days of operation. We'd like to thank the team at Anglian Flight Centres, especially Victoria, Kim and pilot Eddie, for looking after the Essex Ham team so well. Also, our thanks to Captain Nicky, paramedic Louise and Dr. Matt for taking the time to talk to us. Thanks also to the team at the Essex Air Ambulance Trust, especially Jenny, Carly and Jane for making the event possible. Please show your support. Make a donation to the Essex Air Ambulance online or by text now.
It's a really difficult job continuing to raise that huge sum, £440,000 every month. It's your air ambulance, it belongs to you, the community, and we can't fly without you.
This feature was brought to you by Essex Ham, supporting amateur radio in Essex.